In this video, we're going to look at creating an AP adjustment. Go to Applications, Accounts Payable Module, File tab, Payments, and Adjustments. Now, adjustments in AP and in AR, for that matter, are what you would normally call your credit or debit memos. So if you ordered something from a vendor and you needed to return it, and they give you a refund or something, you would create a credit memo so that it would reduce the amount that you owe the vendor. And basically, it just creates a credit for you on that vendor. So the next time you go to pay a bill, you'll have a credit to apply to that particular vendor. Or you could apply it to the specific invoice that it's related to. That's up to you if you get it before you pay the bill. On the AP adjustment screen, you go to Add. You choose your date, choose your vendor. Remember, these fields are dynamic, so you can just start typing in the name. Make sure your contacts are correct, pay to, return to. Now, in AP, the terminology for the type of memo is a little confusing for some people. For a credit memo, you would not select credit memo. You would select debit memo. The debit memo, this is going more on the actual accounting function than the name. A debit memo will reduce the amount that you owe. A credit memo will increase it. In AR, it's the opposite. It's the way you would think about it. A credit memo is a credit memo that reduces what the client would owe you, and the debit memo would increase what they owe you. But in AP, a debit memo is a credit memo or a vendor credit. So just remember that. Adjustment number, this is going to be the ID of the adjustment. Normally, those aren't done often enough to warrant having you put it in on your own, so we auto number them. That's best practice. You could put in a reference bill number. Ideally, you would do this so that you know what bill it relates to. This field is dynamic, so I can start typing in if I know the beginning of the invoice, and I do in this particular case. You can put in a description. You have about 1,000 characters, so you can put in a pretty good description. I'm not going to do that. Put in any backup documentation you want. Select currency. If you're not multi-currency, you won't have this field. This demo is set up for multi-currency. That's why you see all this minutia here. You can choose which account you want to apply the credit to. If you have a refund account, contra account, that's fine. In this case, we're going to do it with the same account that the invoice was for. We'll give it a credit of $500. Choose the project or job. In this case, it's going to be looking to Austin, I believe. You can add a cost code and cost type if you want to. Location is automatically generated because child level that I'm in and the vendor that I chose. If you have a lot of refunds, I don't know why you would, but you may. On a particular invoice, you have your defaults that you saw in bill creation. You can put it in. And for this particular adjustment, it'll auto-populate all the rows. Your project's going to determine location as well. Let's see, it does this. Nice for time saving. Once you have that correct, you can save or draft or post. Draft is a save as, so that you can save your work in progress and come back to it later. When anything is saved in draft, it does not show up anywhere but in that particular field or module that you're in. So it only shows up in AP adjustment. It doesn't show up in any reports. Doesn't show up in the GL, doesn't show up in the subledger until you post. Once you post, it posts. It hits the GL, it hits the subledger. If you have more than one to do, you can do post in new and it'll come up with a new one. It'll post this one and see the record was created successfully and brought up a new screen so you can put in another one. I don't want to do that, so we'll cancel out. And here we have our credit memo. It's a negative because it's a credit memo. A summary title is adjustment. I should have done this beforehand and shown you the vendor and what it looked like in pay bills, but I didn't because I forgot. So you're going to just have to trust me on this. I'll show you here. I don't want to go through all of them, so let's just look for part electric. We'll do a filter. Okay, so here we have it. Now, you'll see The $500 is now a credit that's available for any bill, not just the bill that you had referenced, but it's for any bill. You come through and you set your normal preferences for paying the bill, and then you can choose to add it or delete it. I mean, add it or not use it. You could also break it up. You could like $250 here. And they see it'll automatically reduce that amount by that amount. You could do 50 here. And you could do 200 here. Or if you want to, you don't have to use the whole credit. Whoops. Don't want to do too much, though. I'll give you a big old error on that. And you'll see you still have $100 left in credit for use later. So you can use the credits for everything or nothing. It's up to you on when you use it. You'll have to have your own policy for that. Now, another thing you can do is, I believe I showed it to you in the bills video, is you can apply credit. Click apply, and what it's going to do is going to apply it to the oldest first. So you may not want to do it that way, but that you could do that if you're in a hurry. And like say you just have one Barth invoice and then other invoices. You just do apply credits and apply them across the board. But it's going to do it from oldest to newest. So you don't always want to do that. You can clear credits or you can zero it out. And that's AP adjustments. Just know that this is going to be almost exactly work the same way in AR.